Today's show is brought to you by Fandor. Sign up online or in the app for a free 1 week trial. Just $4.99 a month for your all access pass. Playing now on Fandor is Wake in Fright, a psychological thriller. It follows a young school teacher who descends into personal moral degradation after finding himself stranded in a brutal, menacing town in outback Australia.
Hey everyone, welcome to another Fandor podcast. I got Chris Kelly here with me.
How you doing?
Thank you, Chris, for showing up again, putting up with us. And our amazing producer, Bryn. What's up, Bryn?
Hey, guy.
And our special guest is Lissette. Say her last name.
Lissette. Feliciano.
Feliciano.
Hey, Feliciano.
Lissette's movie. Lissette's movie.
Get it right, Hooman.
Is going to be at the Sonoma Film Festival. Lissette, what is the name of your film?
Hey, guys. Nice to be here. Thank you. My movie is called Women is Losers. It's an intentional title based on a Janis Joplin song from the 1960s.
Nice. Wow. Nice. And, yeah. Now your film is based on true events, correct?
It is, yeah. Inspired by, I think at the opening it says inspired by real women. And it really was just inspired by like the women that I'd grown up with, mostly my mother, but like my grandmothers, my aunts, you know, people from my community, which is the Mission District of San Francisco, and we're all Bay Area people here. So I grew up on 24th Street, 14th Street, between those 10 blocks was more or less where I grew up. And yeah, it's a little bit of my story, a little bit of kind of everybody's in there. If you're a person who has ever struggled for a dream, you're going to see yourself in there for sure.
Tell us what the film's about a little bit, as much as you want to say.
Yeah, no, totally. So it follows a woman named Celina Guerrera, who's inspired by my mom. And, you know, she starts off as like this really promising young like Catholic schoolgirl. She's really smart. She's like really brainy with math, and you know, she has her whole life ahead of her. But just because she's in the circumstances that she is in at the time, you know, in the 60s and 70s, especially for women of color, you know, the feminist movement kind of like missed us a little bit in the 70s. So, you know, she grows up in a very Catholic home, and you know, falls in love with a Vietnam vet. And as things happen, you know, as love, young love goes, you know, they have an unexpected complication, and she's sort of faced with this sink or swim situation of, okay, I'm here, I'm in this situation, I can either do what society's asking me to do, which is essentially stay in the home and give up on my dreams, or I can use any little scrap of advantage that I can find to make a life for myself and my son. And so she becomes, you know, she uses her brains to kind of climb up the ladder and become a wealthy landowner. So
fantastic.
Not a story you really hear too much from women of color of the time. So
tell us about the movie making process, because Chris has made a bunch of movies. I made a film. It's incredible.
Nice.
it's incredible.
It's hard.
Yeah, it's really hard. What was your like hardest day of shooting, or what's one story from the set that you'd love to share with us, or just
my
whatever?
God, we don't even have enough time, you guys. It was insane. It was insane. Like people had always told me, like, make your first movie in one room. I'm sure you guys heard this, right? Because like it's cheap or whatever, and it's easier. But it's like I didn't want to do that. I didn't want my first story to be in one room. And no offense to those movies and stuff like that. Like that's really what's in your heart. But it kind of felt to me like people kept asking me to play small, and so I wanted to do a period piece. I wanted it to be in San Francisco because it's home turf. Mm-hmm. And both of those things are very cost prohibitive for anybody, but definitely for anyone that looked like me. And I said, you know, I'm going to do it anyways. So the hardest part really was shooting on location in the Mission District. A lot of the times we're seeing these movies come out of the indie space in SF, but it's mostly the East Bay or kind of out of the city. Or if it is in the city, it's the financial district. But there's so many communities that don't get seen, you know, like Chinatown, the Fillmore, the Mission District, right? I had never seen those pockets of pockets of groups on film, and now I know why, because it's really really expensive and parking not fun. I guess one of the craziest days, we move locations every day. That was the other thing too. We move locations every day, and like sometimes twice a day. So like we only ever really had like 8 hours of filming, like camera time, maybe six to eight, nine if I got real lucky. So there's a dance sequence in the movie that I think everybody will like when they get to see the movie. And it's a dance sequence that would normally take a week to pull off, right? We pulled that off in one night with the actors learning those dance steps. And thank God for Chrissy Fitt and Lorenza Itzo, who are in the movie. Brian Craigsley Mortiz, they were like doing their scenes and then running off to the auditorium of my high school where we filmed to like rehearse the dance scene and then go and film it like that night. And we were like, all as we were leaving, school was in session. So like we were packing out our equipment like 6 a.m. Wow. And kids and students were starting to come in. It was a mess.
What's happening with your distribution?
I'm very excited that a lot of people are going to get to see it very soon. So we're good.
So what's happening with your distribution? Yeah.
I can't say too much. You know, I can't say.
You can't say anything.
No, so, I can't say anything. But I will say that you will be able to see it very soon.
That's fantastic. That's great to hear.
When you say very soon, do you mean this year?
This year, yeah, I think we'll be able to see it this year. You know, knock on wood, things are still kind of out there. But yeah, we did the festivals really well, Sonoma, thank God.
When is it showing at Sonoma?
August 5th.
Okay,
it's showing August 5th at Sonoma.
And can people come and meet you face to face?
Yeah, I'm gonna be there. I'll be there. I think we're gonna try to get some of the talent out there. So if you're coming out to Sonoma, come have some wine, come watch a movie. Bring your family. It's a really intergenerational movie, I would say. Like, it's grandmothers and aunts and uncles and everybody. Like, bring everybody, because I think what I found after this movie is that the conversations within the family, it just kicks off some conversations that, like, maybe there's stuff that you've kind of swept under the rug with, like, your family that this could help kind of open the conversation on.
All right, listen, I like to end the interviews with a dumb question.
Okay.
I feel like all my questions aren't that great, but
they're all fine. There are no dumb questions.
Tell us your favorite off the beaten path movie.
Oh man, I'm going to get so much trouble. Okay. So I went to Tisch and like, we all had those, like, you know, the very auteur films, and yes, I know the auteur films and I know the canon and all that stuff, but there's one film that I used to get made fun of so badly at school for saying, did you guys ever see Meet Joe Black?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Brad Pitt.
Right? It's literally 3 hours long. Literally. It doesn't even say minutes in the back. They're just like, it's 3 hours. Mm-hmm. And it's Anthony Hopkins, Brad Pitt, and Claire Forlani. And I guess it's based off that Death Takes a Holiday.
Yeah.
And like, if you ever want to see Brad Pitt try to figure out how to eat peanut butter, there's a scene. Or if you want to see the craziest death scene ever.
Isn't that what everyone's looking for?
I know, yeah, seriously. Exactly. It has the craziest death scene in like the first like 10 minutes. I mean, it's not a spoiler alert because it's been 30 years. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that I really like that movie a lot.
Do you like about it? The peanut butter? Like, what
peanut butter.
What stays
Brad Pitt and peanut butter? What more could you ask?
Is that your...
That's the whole sell point.
Is that your celebrity crush? Brad Pitt?
It was at the time, yeah, for sure.
I was going to hear. I hear he's still single.
At the time. No. Yeah. No. It was like a teenager. I like the movie because it's like a cool... I like things that have like weird thought processes, you know, like think out otherworldly things that happen. So like, what does happen with like death comes down to have, you know, a vacation, and like, how does that like interact with all the people in their lives? And I think the acting is actually really good. I like Anthony Hopkins a lot. I'll watch anything. He just won the Oscar for The Father, and I'll watch anything. And I just think it's really funny. It's heartfelt and it's funny. And it is very long. So yeah.
All right, everyone. Her name is Lissette.
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 Yeah, you got it. Lissette.
Feliciano.
Nice.
Feliciano. Yes.
And her film is Women is Losers. It's at the Sonoma Film Festival.
Very much looking forward to seeing it. Thanks
Lissette,
so much.
Thank you so much. And
thanks, guys.
We will be up there, so hopefully we can hang out with you.
Yay, that'll be awesome. Nice to meet you, and thanks so much for having us.
And congratulations for getting it
done.
You.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
See you soon. It.
Thanks so much.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thanks for tuning in. Just a friendly reminder, sign up online or in the app for a free 1 week trial. Playing now on Fandor is Wake in Fright, a psychological thriller. It follows a young school teacher who descends into personal moral degradation after finding himself stranded in a brutal, menacing town in outback Australia. That's FAN DOR, Fandor, the home for cinephiles.